American Cooling and Heating has the right team and the right stuff. Call anytime. Even weekend service at no extra charge. Who does that anymore? American Cooling and Heating. They'll treat you like family.
On October 19th, we will have our monthly meeting for the Amite Chamber. That meeting will be at the arena with guest speaker, State Treasurer John Schroeder. But we do have our tables. The tables are $150, and we are selling single seats for $25 per seat. The Bon Appetit event, as many of you know, that is our largest fundraiser of the year. That will be November 10th at 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. The tickets are being printed, but the prices will be $40 at the door and $30 in advance. If anybody wants to purchase a ticket in advance, please get with Brittany. We will send out an email on Facebook, and post on Facebook. And we are also actively seeking new board members for the 2023 year. I just spoke with someone who may be interested in being a board member, but you guys, we would like for you to participate. The board is active in getting everything together. We plan all of the lunches, we plan the meetings that we have monthly. So we need new people to come in and join the board. We have some members that are coming off this year, so we need some fresh faces. You guys, please get with me or Brittany if you're interested in being a board member for 2023. We will now have our guest speaker, Mr. Kelly Wells from the Florida Parish Arena. Let's give him a hand clap.
I find it still amazing that after almost 19 years in existence as a nice event center for our parish, that there are still people who question where it is and what goes on there. We're proud to have it. I've been the director since 2004, and so we've done a lot. All the different groups that have held events, the events that take place at the facility, that's what drives the place. You know, I have a phenomenal staff. I have a few full-time folks. Y'all know Ms. Tony Jean, she's our office administrator. Alvin Stevens and Lane Talion, his brother. They're our other two full-time employees. Without them, the place wouldn't go. They're the cogs in the wheel and the spokes in the wheel that keeps things moving and keeps things clean. But it's actually the producers of the events, the organizations, the people that come into the facility that have the events that make it work. On September 23rd and 24th is the Tangipahoa Parish Sheriff's Office, the Posse's Rodeo. It's the 11th annual rodeo that they've held at the facility. It will be two nights. It is one of the two largest rodeos that we have at the facility. It's absolutely a great time. Jill Hutchinson, who is an officer with TPSO, does a tremendous job in leading the posse. She has the support of all the deputies and a lot of people. They get a lot of sponsors, and it is a good, clean time. Come up, bring the kids, bring grandma and grandpa, whomever. Everybody will enjoy the rodeo. That's one thing about rodeos as opposed to some of the other events that take place at the facility. A lot of them are organizational driven. Like this weekend, we have barrel racing and a barrel racing clinic. We have a lot of that. And we do have spectators, but the rodeo is one of those things that you can bring the family out once or twice a year, enjoy it. Even though you may not have an animal or farms back home, you can still go participate and enjoy the nice activities there. October 14th through the 16th, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, we're going to have Vintage Market Days. We're on to our sixth year with Vintage Market Days. They've signed up for another five-year contract, so we'll have them for four more years, twice a year. And y'all, that's a big deal. A lot of people come into our community for that. They'll have over 10,000 people come through the doors those 3 days. That brings a lot of traffic to Amite. Everyone from the Waffle House to Mike's to the Boston to La Coretta to Walmart. We like to think that everybody gets to participate, have a good time. Even if you don't want to really purchase anything, you can get a ticket, walk through, get some good food, listen to some live music, and just kind of be a part of a nice atmosphere and a nice activity. Something that's coming up the weekend after that that we haven't had in over 9 years, monster trucks are coming back to the arena. You know, people say, God, you can have monster trucks in the arena? Yes, we can. We actually had them for numerous years. The company that produced them went out of business, and they're still friends of ours. But this young man who was part of that back in the day, he started his own company. He does this nationwide from California to the East Coast. And he put us on his tour route this year. So that Friday and Saturday, monster trucks will take place. It's the same exact monster trucks that take place in the Superdome. They go to the Superdome. The kids can sit on the tires at the pre-show party, whatever, meet the drivers. They will watch the same things take place in a smaller footprint. They will be much closer to the trucks. How many of you been there for Monster Trucks years ago? Any of y'all? A few of y'all? It was a good time. And I think that everybody will see that it's a good time again. And he hopes to, if it's a success, to continue with that. Our event center, that's the arena. And we are booked every weekend with something. But we have the event center as well. And the event center is where Bon Appetit will be held. I think, right? We have our date for Bon Appetit that will be later this fall. Yeah, our event center is used pretty much on a daily basis. We have training going on today for a department. Holiday season is around the corner. If you or your company or your family or somebody wants to have a Christmas event, now's the time to book it. I mean, I do like to spread the word that the rental is available. We're not going to ever get into the business of purchasing ads for the event center because we are public owned, and we don't want to ever make our private partners in the community and in the parish feel as though we're trying to head up and be necessarily stiff competition for them. But it's just another alternative, because many people know as they'll go to different venues and things may be booked up. So we're just another option for folks. Y'all, we've had a lot of upgrades at the facility over the past couple years. When COVID hit, we did have to shut down for a couple months like everyone. So we took advantage of that opportunity, went to our parish council, our administration, Robbie, our parish president, Joe Thomas, Jeff McNeely, those administrators, they kind of worked with us. Andy Careers, our public works director. We all partnered up together and came up with some ideas of how we would tackle some infrastructure projects, deferred maintenance, because we have such short windows in between events. We said, okay, we're going to take advantage of this time where we had to be closed to tackle some things that we needed to do. We had to paint that facility that hadn't been painted in over 18 years. And actually, we learned the beams, when they were delivered to the arena back in 2002 and 2003, during the construction, those beams were primed. They were never even painted. It looked nice, but I mean, there was never a finish coat on it. So money was allocated, and we spent right at $250,000 to paint that facility. We're engaging right now with a group putting brand new sound system, or upgrading the sound system in the facility. We're constantly working on our footing. You know, a lot of things that have taken place too with the recreation park next to us. You know, the ball fields that are there, it's our neighbors. So we are working in conjunction, trying to help them a little bit, keeping the outfields bush hogged, things like that, to make it a nice view between the two areas. Our parking out front is available quite a few times when we're not having an event that's going to use our front lot. Therefore, the ball field can use that front lot. So we share resources like that. There's just so many things going on. Craig?
Will they share the RV hookups?
We have six out front that they can utilize, and we have had them utilize that. Not if we're having an event in the back that's utilizing them, the ones that near the barn. But we work hand in hand. Here it's a communication thing. We kind of look at each other's calendars and make sure that we're planning the best we can. And because here again, we want to be greedy, I want to say. Greedy in the sense that we want outside visitors to come into our parish, experience the hospitality that we have, and leave their tax dollars here, and then they can go home and enjoy their families with their wherever they may be living. But we do want to be entertainers of our guests, and we think that Amite's a perfect place to have people come in and visit for whatever event may be presented. Here a couple weekends ago, Miss Erica Taylor, Miss Taylor is the new owner of WABO Radio. Miss Taylor had an event at the arena in the event center. Cross section of the community, everything from schools have had proms there, churches have had events there, family reunions. But we also have used it for Amite, Sumner, Kentwood, Oak Forest have all used the facility to practice indoor with football when they've had bad days, and we've let them come up and practice. And now they're not able to do all their drills the same way they would on a football field, but at least they're under a covered roof. We had graduation when COVID was going on. Independence High School had graduation at the facility. Was it the perfect place for a high school graduation? Maybe, maybe not, but at least they were able to have a graduation and invite friends and family to come and watch them walk across the stage. So we try to be very versatile, try to be open-minded and think outside of the box. We charge $25 a night for our RV spots. That's water and electric, and we do have a dump station out front. And that's what we charge. That's been the charge for years. We haven't really gone up on those. But here again, kind of like the event center, we're not trying to compete against our campgrounds. We want our campgrounds to flourish and campgrounds to help bring people into our community. For the most part, the RV spots there, we call them RV spots, but they're pretty much trailer spots because it's usually the ones that are plugging in or horse trailers with living quarters that are adapted to be able to be plugged in. Because quite frankly, when we have an event going on, and we do have some people that are traversing the country and they know that we're a facility, so they'll stop in, rent an RV spot for a night, plug in. There may be people traveling from Florida to Texas. We got a lot of people, 15 minutes up the interstate from I-12 is not that far for them to know they have a safe place to come. To plug in, to get back on the road, to head back towards Texas. There's a lot of animals that travel this country, and we get to see a lot of them here. One thing people ask all the time, too, is how much does it cost? Well, it costs different amounts. We stay consistent, but it's different amounts based upon the event and how many days. If you have a Friday, Saturday, Sunday event, we're going to give you a couple dollars break on each day because you're having a multi-day event versus just a one-day event. So things like that. In a ticketed event is a little more. We have very few ticketed events. Most events are just open. The gates are open and most people can just come in and watch. The rodeos, the monster trucks, those are ticketed events. And we're not the one selling the tickets. We will sell tickets for a producer, but we as the facility do not put on events. We are a facility that can basically host one equine major event at a time. How many of y'all have heard of Lamar Dixon over in Gonzales? It's a much bigger facility. They can host four or five events at the same time. We know you come to our facility, you're basically the only game in town. And our staff is going to cater to you like that. We've got events from some of our sister facilities because they like the attention and they like the service that they get with us that sometimes you're not able to do when you're trying to host multiple events. Because I'm one person, I have 100% of my energy. If I have five events I have to attend to, then each of those events are gonna get 20%. But if I have one event that I gotta attend to, they're gonna get my focus. And that's kind of the way that we look at it. We host one event, we want to host it good, we want to make our residents proud.
Great news. There's someone you can call for fast, reliable service on your air conditioning. American Cooling and Heating, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Friendly people who are experts at what they do. 25 years in business with lots of satisfied customers. Old-fashioned service plus the wherewithal to get the job done right. American Cooling and Heating,